All I can say is, I'm sorry. Literally, this is so stupid. The only reason why I'm doing this stream is because I was just sitting on my bed randomly. I'm like, man, what if I did a Celestra and my file poo flu? I hate everything. This is so stupid. Oh, goodness. Ugh. This is so dumb. I'm so sorry. It probably sounds really stupid when I don't have the music playing. So we're doing another speedrun attempt. Still trying to shave under the hour. I can't believe I'm doing this. This is so stupid. I hate myself. I'm listening to Drop Pop Candy. It's such an earworm. A trick here where I could grab onto the top platform before landing on the ground, but I haven't been able to pull it off with a switch. I mean, I'm pretty sure I had like way better reaction times on the PC just because I played on it a lot more. But oh, this is easy. That was bad. Oh, that was real bad. Frick. Mobby. RIP. Yeah, this is not a good level one. I don't think I'm gonna get my sub hour. Actually, at this point, I've been hoping for like a sub 10. I have not been hitting that. It's just more like, at this point, I need to brush up on sub techniques and build up muscle memory. It's definitely a switch going from PC to joystick. There's like advantage, like I basically pull off diagonals. Wow, that was stupid. Hi, Lynn! I pull off diagonals way better. I don't know why I dashed there. But in exchange, I can't do like cardinal directions as well. So the whole reason why I'm doing this stream is because I named the file poop. It's so dumb. The 213 is not good. I can usually get under a minute or under 2 minutes, not under a minute. Oh jeez, I wish. I got the dang poo flu. I'm also listening to a song in the background, so I'm gonna start karaokeing to it. Thank you. gotta build up the muscle memory for these directions. They're still- I could tell, like, they're very rigid on my Switch controller. I had way better reaction times on my, what's it called? On my keyboard. It's not the difference between the keyboard and the controller, that's just my muscle memory in response to it. Like, I definitely always seem to go in directions that I do not mean to go to. That's like failure more on my part than the controller. Like, the joystick is really sensitive. So like, the bigger problem is, my brain already knows the other direction I'm going to. So that's what throws off like my directions, because I want to go like, say I want to do horizontal, but I'm like, oh, I'm about to go up, and then I do an up diagonal instead of what I intended to do. And that messes me up a lot. That was dumb. No! Why didn't you touch the shield, Madeline? What? Man, the hitbox of these spikes, I swear. Not a good level two. Okay, maybe if I stop singing, I'll stop sucking at this run. Yeah, the point of all these practice runs is really just to build up muscle memory. I mean, getting better times is good too, but... Okay, let's see. Pooflu! I hate this level the most. Thank you. hope Pooflu becomes like our next in our crazy series of Rewind File names. Like 12 pizzas. No! No! Land on the spring! No! Madeline! Direction on the Pro Controller. I always make this mistake. Always. Hold that far! Switch seems to be like an hour 20, so it's like a lot to shave off. I need to remember what my old strats were. Like, there was like this one like ground dash trick I could do on the PC, and I can't figure out how to do it again. It's like you're supposed to dash like the second your pixel hits the ground or something like that. It's like, it's less complicated than wave dashing, but I always did it via muscle memory rather than like actual technique. That's why I can't like pull it off again for some reason. Like, I have spurts of it. This level has always been like my weakness. I will always have the hardest time to break. It also doesn't help that I'm terrible with pursuit, which is what this level ends on. But like, I think like this level is like really hard for a lot of people because of the cycle of the things. Because that can really like throw in a lot of unneeded extra seconds. Cycles of this level make this like way harder than it should be. Like level 5 is understandably hard. This level is just like hard. Like I honestly have a lot harder time with this than I do with 4 and 6. I mean 5 is hard, but that's like 11. It's supposed to be like this weird equalizer. It's also an S4 mission, so 5 is like pretty tough. Like, and the problem is the way that the D-pad is positioned on the Pro Controller, it honestly should just not even be there because it's unusable. See, I get it, like, it was trying to simulate, like, the Joy-Cons, but I really wish it didn't. It really should have just been a Pro Controller. Because that's really what throws me off a lot. A lot of things. And, like, it's a big time waster if I had to sit there and actually, like, force my muscle memory to like do a certain direction, because it I really need to train my like muscle memory to like make it automatic. It's just a lot more sensitive with the Joy-Cons. Maybe there's like a sensitivity. On the cycle before I died. Sometimes when I do like a diagonal jump, I have more of a boost, and that's like one of the tricks, but I can't remember how I did it. It just kind of happens, so I gotta get better at controlling it. Get that it's the last room of it, but it's just so messy, this room. This is honestly my worst room in the entire game, I think. Every other room, I'm willing to take. Even, like, the Escort Theo room mission. This room, even the last section, do we even really need this? Like, I get it. Oh, I get it. Like, this room sucks. Don't gotta rub it in. See, another theory I like to have is, if I can get like under 100 deaths, I'll have like a really good time. But I always tend to have like deaths. I mean, like I'll get them under 200, which is good, but they really do add up, like seconds. That was dumb. Actually, I think that, like, that diagonal boost is from, like, entering a room. So that's not the boost I'm trying to figure out how to relearn. Yeah, that was dumb. There's a dash there. Jumps. Okay. I saw the TV remote. No! Oh my freaking word, are you serious? What is happening? Okay, I can barely pay attention to chat while I'm running, so. Also, what's MC? Like, that's not how you spell Animal Crossing. I don't even know why that cloud is there. I don't even need it! Oh, you know what I think that cloud is there for? I think you can use the cloud to get that, like, third platform, if you do it right. Because I think I've done that before, I just can't remember how. Oh, that's bad. Yep, that's bad. I would have made it if I wasn't, like, if I didn't, like, lose my dash. No! did you do that? That was stupid. That was mean! That's a very bad run. Because I can usually do this under 7 minutes. Actually under 6 if I like. Didn't suck. Oh! Sub 100 deaths is dead. Dead. Maybe I'll do all of chapter 5 without dying. LOL. Dream. Thank you. Nailed it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. No, thank you! Forget over here not to freaking dash because the platforms are controlled by dashing. I was literally just thinking to myself, man, this is a really good chapter 5, and then this room's happening. Oh, he almost killed me. I almost died. Stop it! I just thanked you, you fool! A good chapter 5 all depends on Theo. He is the rise and fall of this chapter. Oh. So there's like a trick to this room. Like you could you could drop Theo there and then get the thing at the same time. LOL, I don't know the trick. As you can tell, I don't know the trick. Or, well, it's more accurate to say I'm just not good at the trick, because I clearly know about it. Stop! Oh, nah! 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 It's because I laughed. I'm very angry. No! Theo! I murdered Theo. Gotta stop murdering Theo. It's bad. Let's go. Let's go. See, this room is like... Oh. Rip Theo. This room is like worse than the last room in level 3. Except it's not. Like this room, I'd rather do this room 10 times than do the room in chapter, like the last room of chapter 3, like once. You can do this, Pooh-Flu! You got this, Pooh-Flu! Why would you do that? Wow, Theo doesn't even want to talk to me. Freaking rude. Theo! Me the wrong direction. That was so mean. Level would be so much better if he wasn't in it. He's the reason why it's hard, because of the desperate mission. Theo! Hit the eye! Flex. Pooh-Flu, you cannot outrun your own reflection. That feather, it's fine. Ow. Oh, whoops. Wow, I'm already messing this up. Oh, jeez. Yeah, nailed it. Oh, because my name's Pooh-Flu, you're not gonna hear the cool wahahahahas. Sorry, I guess. Man, I forgot what these sounded like normally. Oh, no. big window too, so I don't know how I kept missing it. Why'd you do that? Oh, that was mean. Oh, that was also mean. Giving me carpal tunnel. Okay, Madeline? Madeline? We gotta get through the hole, Madeline! Why are you scared, Madeline? Madeline. Ow. No! Madeline! Ha 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 ha! success. Let's go! No, I missed. Ugh. I don't know why I thought I could get that. That was bad. Ah! No, stop! Why would you switch attacks? I knew the moment the flow got ruined, it was gonna be. I don't know how that counted. Whatever, I'll take it! Yay! Ha! I will say this, definitely the controller is way better. The way better for the feather. Feather was really, really bad for me. Ah, you're supposed to dash Madeline. No! Oh. I don't know why I tried to duck. Did you a favor? You aren't a mountain climber! I'm just trying to help you! Skip cutscene. Ow! I do not have a good position as well. Just stand on the edge. I was gonna be there. She rebounded. thought of that. Oh! No! That was mean. If I had just taken one less freaking jump. Madeline! Why did you miss the feather? What? Are you serious? That was too high? Oh, but that was low. Okay. Okay, game. Oh, Madeline. Oh, you. It's your fault for bonking. Oh, Madeline. Oh, Madeline. I love that you can miss the giant spring there. Like, cool, I guess. Why aren't you getting the spring, Madeline? Okay, let's do that. Oh, Madeline! You silly biscuit. Something that gives you like such a wide window to fall from and you still get hit by it. Ah, game design. Game design! Direction I wanted you to go. What the frick? Oh, Madeline. You poo-flu. Today I'm just gonna take my time in that room, and it will save me much more time than I feel like it does. I'm gonna like rush through and just die like 8 times. Ow. I literally hit the pixel of my freaking hair. Oh, that was mean. Madeline, you should have dashed. You had another one. This is why you have 2 dashes. Madeline, no! Deathless, let's go. Yeah, Deathless, let's go! No! Ow. No, Madeline. Bamboozled! Madeline. I don't know why I'm not having a good luck in this class tonight. I basically killed my level 4. Deathless level 5, let's go! What the heck? Thank you. Madeline! I don't know why I always have trouble with this room in particular. Like, this is my problem with, like, Summit 5. Ugh. Also, I have a very switching Madeline. Change directions last minute. Wait for me. Oh, thank goodness we're leaving. Madeline, yeah, suck. Okay, I can dash. I'm doing it. Wow, Madeline. I guess you can't really keep it there. Don't play Animal Crossing on speedrunning! Also, you just got Persona 5 Royal! Why are you playing Animal Crossing? So, one of my friends apparently got One of my friends apparently got Persona 5 Royal already. Like, their GameStop was doing like an early release of pre-orders. Why is everyone playing Animal Crossing at the same time? It's like 9 o'clock at night. Isn't like all the Animal Crossing stuff closed at 9 o'clock at night? Trying to encourage the children to go to bed? No, Madeline! You had it! Oh, nah. Oh, Madeline. That's what you get for bombing. Thank you. Oh, Madeline! Why you gotta be like this? So many flags. Me and Clouds today are not friends. Maybe only reaction time is bad today. Not been having a good time at all today, jeez. Madeline! It was right there. Reach out your stubby little arms and grab it. Oh, Madeline! You bad child! Oh, Madeline. Oh, Madeline. Fuck. Oh, Madeline! You idiot! Ah! she exploded before she even, like, left the screen. Amazing. No! Madeline! Oh. I hate when the music fades out, because, like, if you die here, which you very well still can, it's so awkward. Well, that was a really bad run. Pooflu is cursed! Pooflu is cursed. Let's see. Let's do some B-sides. I'm gonna hate this. I'm gonna hate this so much. Pooflu is cursed. Wow. I totally is so bad that I came from this, like, after stupid summit. Cause now I'm used to having two dashes. Nope, not a win. What am I doing? Coming here after summit was a mistake. There's a thing on there, frick. Socks, I can't. It must hurt to climb with that Pooflu. No. Oh no. No! No! Madeline! Oh no! Oh no! Oh. What? No, why'd you climb up? Ugh. Huh? No! Ah! 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 I hate this level. I hate a lot. Ow! No! Ow. Ow. No! Why did you do that? I should have just let go. No! Ow. No! Bye. No! That was dumb. No! Catch! Why did you not catch? I did it! Go. Ow. Ow. Oh. Oh no. No! That is not where I expected my death to come from. I also did not expect to live, and then I died there. Ow. Ah! No. Madeline, catch the wall! Nailed it. Bucket. Gotti. Aha! No. Why? Stop that. That would have been perfect if I had gotten all the shields. So, hey. No. No! You need to stop sliding, Madeline. Not keep sliding! You gotta! No! Why's it gotta be like this? No! No. That was not how that was supposed to go. Bye-bye. No! Look how scared the child is. No! No! Oh! 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 No! Nailed it. No! Why'd you gotta do me like that? Nah. Oh! Oh! No! Gotta give me time! No! Yeah. Nailed it. No. Why'd you jump so high? No. Why? No! What'd you do that? Madeline. Madeline! Gaga go. No! I trusted in the game. No! Madeline! Why'd you can't do that? Ha ha! Ho ho! Hee hee! I died. Nailed it. Fuck it! Cupcakes! Yeah, ow! No. Man, if you think you hate Chapter 3... I mean, his B-side is kind of like the other B-sides. I just still hate Chapter 3. I just want another reason to hate it. No! No! Madeline! Yeah. No return. Blockbuster! Ow! Red box! 30-day lease! Nope! Nope. scared. No. Nailed it. Nope. Nope. Bye. Nope. Go Krispies! I'm alive. No! I'm not alive. Okay. Ouch. No. Rude! I was just trying to live my life. And you gotta be all like, I'm up in your here. Ow. Chico! Fury! Fragile! This side up! Return! Oh, I'm alive. No. No! I'm not alive. Kojima. No. No. I must have died in this room like 100 times already. Wow. Oh! Oh. Don't let go. Don't let go! So much for the dream! Ah. Bye. Bye. Got it. Why'd you do that? Rude! Nailed it. Why'd you just like hover there? Rude. Nailed it! Ugh. Nailed it. Nailed it. I do not like Chatterbox design. Oh, there's a save point here, thank goodness. I'm about to go freaking get dinner. Ow. Ow. Why didn't you go up, Madeline? Why didn't you go up? Didn't make it. Ow. Nailed it! Hello! No! Ow. No, you're fine, Lynn. Ow! You know who needs help? Madeline! Bye-bye! Oh! Okay. No. No! Okay, so you know what? I think I need a dash, but... Oh. Oh, no! Now I know! Now I know what to do, and I hate it! I hate chapter 3! Hello. Bye-bye. You should have caught me when I was doing my speedrun. I was actually doing, like, not ducking. Okay. Okay! That's not it. Ouch. Yeah, chapter 3's B-side sucks. You know, it's really weird. I did chapter, like, 5's B-side. I did... Believe it or not, you guys. I did this. I did this on the PC. I just can't do it on Twitch. No! Oh. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. No! Stop playing Pokemon Shield! Ow! Ow! Now let's do speedrun again. How did I do this? Nailed it! Nope. I need the dash for there. Best idea! Yeah! Whoa, that was dumb. Y'all wanna play sushi games? B-sides are a nightmare. I did this before! How did I do it? That was a mystery of the past. This is back when I was a good gamer. Now I'm an adult with, like, a job. That's my excuse. I did this since, like, 2018. It's not 2018 anymore. That's why I can't do it. To recover the dash, and I have to use it there. Nailed it. Yo, do you guys want to do another speedrun? Just do another speedrun. Let me make sure it's saved. I'm gonna be very sad when it didn't, and I have to do that again. Oh, thank goodness. I love you, game. Okay, let's do another speedrun. Fingers hurt, so that's already bad. Okay. Speedrun and then dinner, hooray! This is a plan. Ow! Did you know that if you pull away and you're wearing a headset, it's a bad idea? Ouch. Good job, Madeline. Nailed it. Oh, my word. Nailing it! Okay, let's restart this file. Maybe when I don't yank the headphones out of my ears, it'll be good. The one thing to keep in mind in that one is getting the most run for your jump. Nailed it. There we go. That's better. Hey. Oh, I almost died. Okay. I can do this. Oh no. Okay. Her little feet are so cute. Should. It's a good soundtrack. That's the reason why, like, you can even endure the B-side. It's because it's a really good mix. Because, oh my goodness, otherwise B-sides are a nightmare. Good job, Madeline. Nailed it. Like Toho games, the only thing that gets me through the impossible levels are music. I need to climb. I'll take the 213 with the deaths. Fortunately, all the soundtracks are on Bandcamp. Or Spotify. Or Spoofy, if you'd like to call it Spoofy. Here we go. Spoofy! That's what matters. I know, I really want this game, like, physically. Well, I have it physically. The whole reason why I even have it on Switch is because I got the collector's edition. It was quite a fight. It's kind of funny too, like the only reason why I wanted the collector's edition was for the steel case. I didn't even want everything else. Like, if they had just sold it as a steel case, that was stupid. If they had just sold it as a steel case, I would have just got that. I don't need all the bells and whistles. Especially not plushy. Though the plushie is very soft, so I like the plushie. Oh, that was so scary. Okay. Not a win. Yeah. Oh. No. No. But Celeste, the music person was at MAGFest this year, wasn't she? Wow, that was really stupid. Did she have any physical merch? I mean, I think they had like the cassettes. I don't know if she had any CDs. Madeline, stop slipping. You're inside, you're not even on ice right now. Nailed it! diagonal, I guess. Wow, what is happening? That's diagonal. Come on, let's go. Labyrinth. Not labyrinth. Okay. Don't go in there. Don't go in there again. Someone is playing Lego City Undercover. Oh, it wasn't this year. I was wondering if she sold, like, her merch. But then again, if she's, like, a musical guest, I guess she doesn't have to, like, really bring the merch. She just... Ow. She just probably performs and does autographs. Ow. Ah, yes, Fangamer. That's where I got the collector's edition. I missed the original limited run. I had to like refresh Fangamer at a time when I shouldn't have been buying stuff, but I bought it anyway. It takes come with a lot of goodies, though. Iron on patches and stuff. All I really wanted was the steelbook, though. No, why'd you do that? Ow. I almost thought like Fangamer was in Fairfax. No, that's ThinkGeek. ThinkGeek's in Fairfax, which is crazy. Then again, that's still like 3 hours away from us, so. It's more in like Northern Virginia. Where all the called business people are. Fangamer has a nice. I've been meaning to get like a Ralsei plushie. I need to get a Temmie plushie first. I hate this part. It always gives me a scare. Ah! That was so bad. Yeah, I have no idea where Fangamer is. I feel they're like west. I feel like San Francisco sounds familiar. I could be wrong. It's probably like Kentucky or something. Oh. No. Yeah, it's definitely west coast. Then again, I always got mad at ThinkGeek for giving me like terrible shipping price. Like it wasn't terrible shipping, but it was just like the same shipping as everybody else. And I was like, you're 3 hours away. I could drive to your warehouse and get my stuff. Well, I probably wouldn't. Madeline, why did you do that kind of jump? You're supposed to just do a normal jump, like a normal person. And why'd I do that? I was stupid. Arizona! Easy. There's like this print from Fangamer that I've been always needing to get. I never get it. It's their Shovel Knight print. Of Shovel Knight catching Shield Knight. I didn't get that, like, I think they're running out. Oh. Well, it's like an old print, so it's not like old, but like they've had it for years and I just never got it. I want more Shovel Knight merch. I don't really want like the I do like the amiibos, but I'm not gonna use them. Whoops. But yeah, I need to get like the Temmie and the Ralsei plushie. I really like Ralsei. Nailed it! Oh yeah, that's how I know that Fangamer isn't local. They never come to our local cons. We'll definitely go for MagFest, because MagFest is a big gaming one. I know they're probably always at GDQs because like they freaking sponsor GDQ. Yeti as well. I like my Yeti shirts. I'm actually really sad because like my new job, I'm actually really not allowed to wear t-shirts at all. So like all those all those Yeti t-shirts I bought are just, I can't wear them to work. I'm very sad. I mean, I guess I could just wear them once. Madeline, no. Madeline, no. Yeah, exactly. GDQ makes sense because they sponsor them. Okay, bye-bye, Block. I didn't need you. I know there are speedrunner tricks to not use this block, though. I don't think I've ever pulled them off. I did this trick once, in that, like, I could immediately grab the block without using the wall there. But that was once upon a time. And the logistics. But yeah, usually like though for Fangamer, if I really was concerned about shipping, if you wait till like the holidays, they usually do like a free shipping type of deal for like a certain amount of an order. I wonder what big indie game they're gonna do next. They basically got Celeste and they got Undertale. What other big indie games that came out recently? Or big popular indie games? Oh yeah, they definitely got Cuphead. I think freaking GameStop was trying to fight for Cuphead too. Oh, maybe Indivisible. That's pretty popular. Oh yeah, Hollow Knight. Yeah, they definitely like were pimping out Hollow Knight. In fact, like I think I saw Hollow Knight stuff on Fangamer before I even knew what Hollow Knight freaking was. Sadly, I'm not, like, not into Hollow Knight. I can't really do Metroidvanias. But Hollow Knight is a good game from what I've seen. It's not even that I don't like Metroidvanias, I don't like the coloring. I don't like dark colored games. That's why I never really liked Twilight Princess. I mean, I love it. I love the story of Twilight Princess. I just don't. Playing the game gives me a headache. It's really weird. Like, the game's atmosphere, like, hurts my eyes, like, from the beginning. But then, like, the actual Twilight parts, like, where you're the wolf, that actually gives me a headache. It's weird. It's sad too, because I can't enjoy I can't enjoy Twilight Princess as much as I want to. But give me Wind Waker Skyward Sword! Yeah. I know it's weird, it's just like the coloring. It's also weird because like usually I think like oversaturated colors gives people like a headache. But like, it's weird that like dull, muted stuff gives me a headache. I guess it's like more of a strain on the eyes. I'll take that. I don't need the bubble. Yeah. Nailed it. Oh yeah, Golf Story. That game looks cute. Very, what's it called? They combined like a golf game with an RPG, with RPG elements. I know, I kind of wanted to give it a try, but like, I fell out of RPGs because I don't have time anymore. I swear, like, the only reason why I was even able to buckle down and beat Octopath Traveler was because I was unemployed. That reminds me. So, guys, like, the intern that I have, like, his assignment. So, like, he doesn't really know how to program, and I don't know how to program either. So, like, I told him, okay, you know how you're gonna make your game? You're gonna make it in Twine! I made this poor child use Twine. Twine's a great program, though, don't get me wrong. I joke it because I love it so much. It's such a great, like, it's a great, simple program that, like, it's so versatile. Especially for people like me who don't know freaking code. Also, I like dating sims, so of course I'm gonna like a game that's fine. Now, like, I have friends that are bad at RPGs, too. It's like, it's very hard to keep your focus in an RPG. Because, like, the best way for it to tell stories is for it to be long form. But it's hard to keep your focus when you're grinding. So, I feel that. Like, I only used to be really good at them when I was younger, because I don't know, like, why I could, like, buckle down on it. I could buckle down so much better when I was younger, but now I just don't have the time. Which is so weird. Because I had, like, homework all the time when I was a kid. Etc. But also, it's because, like, I have, like, money to buy video games now, and when I was a kid, like, I always had to ask, and then, like, I only had, like, one game a year, so of course I was gonna buckle down and, like, finish it. The true reason why I had, like, 300 hours in, like, JRPGs is because that was the only game I would have for an entire year. Oh. I know, like, it's, I know it's a virtual console and stuff, but, like, yeah, it's... Because, like, the frustrating thing about RPGs is, like, when you lose a boss fight or something, and then you waste all that time. That's why it can also be, like, hard to stream as well. Because it's so much more magnified when you waste time on stream, because you see the time. But yeah, like, I use streams to help me keep my focus in RPGs. I probably wouldn't even have finished, like, Octopath on my own if I didn't stream it. I don't even know how I finished freaking Persona 5. I mean, like, work was a little more lax then, I guess. Oh, Temple 5. I love the backwards message. I think that's really cute. Ah! This level is definitely the one I'm scared of the most in this game, but it's not the worst, because the worst is 3. That's dumb. I'm actually scared of, like, the Medusa monsters. They're so scary. That was so bad. It's weird, like, Earthbound has always been kind of hard to stream, but, like, Chrono Trigger, like, wasn't that bad for me. Like, Earthbound's a great game, don't get me wrong. It's just that it's a little more grindy. Because it's like... The Mother games have kind of always been like that, because Mother 3 was also the same. Like, there's a randomness to the narrative, which is fine. But, like, in keeping your focus, it's tough. Like, Chrono Trigger, oddly enough, is more linear, even though you're bouncing all across the timelines. Like, there's a more linear storytelling to it. Mother games have, like, that kind of Pokemon element, but Pokemon's also more linear than other games. Oh yeah, I think I've done that for a lot of like stuff too. Like if it's just a boring grind, I don't like force a stream out of it because then I just feel bad. Yeah. Like, Earthbound's a very, like, yeah, it's you're right. It's like, it's a very micro narrative. And, like, what, like, for JRPGs, a lot of people are more used to, like, a more macro narrative, like, a more dynamic, like, the thing about Earthbound's narrative is that it's definitely, it has that feeling of most JRPGs kind of have that everything revolves around you. And Earthbound definitely, like, Earthbound does the exact opposite. Like, there's a lot of things going on without you. And it's like, you get to take part. And it's actually really cool how that works. It's like a more community aspect of it. That's definitely what I loved about Mother 3. It's like, you're going around helping people, but they also go around helping you. In most JRPGs, it's like, you go around, get the... Why did you get the shield? Okay, you can get that one. That's right. It's very cute in Mother because it's like, or just in the Mother series, it's because it's people that you help, but they also help you. So there's a very symbiotic thing with it, element with it. Oh, cool. Not cool! Yeah, it's all about community and Mother. It's very cute. Like, even your typical JRPG party, like, you're not stronger than them, which is so great. Like, you definitely, you're like the best average. Like, I know like a lot of JRPGs do that. It's not all about, they don't usually make the main character OP. Like, a lot of times they do. Like, in most JRPGs, they make them OP. Die. Don't die. which, you know, it makes sense, because, like, you know, and naturally, like, the main character, your Ness, your Lucas, is going to be, like, the more versatile to use, but, like, everyone has something to bring to the table, which I thought was a nice, like, element. Come on. Come on. It's a very, that's a very nice thing about, like, Mother games. Like, that's honestly, I think the laconic of Mother games, you're not alone. Like, that's the, binding element of all of them, which is a very nice message. And that's why I honestly think that's the draw for Mother games for a lot of people, because a lot of people need to hear that sometimes, that you're not alone. And, like, it's really interesting that they use the vessel of an RPG to communicate that. Because, like, the rhetoric that most RPGs give is that, like, okay, the world needs you. Which is a good narrative to have, because, like, people need that in stories. Like, that's why people love fictional stories. Because people need that. They need, like, that kind of, Oh yeah, totally. I never hate watching, like, Earthbound streams. They're so good. But yeah. That's why I love the narrative for JRPGs. And, like, that's, like, a lot of the empowerment of video games themselves. Giving people a sense of purpose. You know, like, a lot of people, like, make fun. It's like, oh, but it's fictional. It's not real. I'm like, you know what? It's real to me. And it, like, even if it, like, isn't quote-unquote real, the feeling is the same. Like, you know, I know it's, sometimes it's fun to, like, do chaos and stuff, but, like, at the end of the day, like, most people want to be the hero. Ow. I also don't want to die to this stupid Medusa monster. I hate this thing. Ow. Not cool. See, I have a trick to this guy. There we go. Just had to do it. That was not it. Ah, you're a tech simulator. Yeah, my current comfort right now, like if I ever need a game to relax, it's still Civ 5. It's just like, I mean, I play on like easy mode, whatever, easy baby mode, but it's like, I like building stuff. Which I imagine is usually the comfort people get from Minecraft, and definitely the Hero Truck Simulator. It's just riding around. Oh, Breath of the Wild too, I just like riding around my horse. Yeah. Definitely Splatoon, not Splatoon, well I mean Splatoon doesn't calm me down either, but Celeste is definitely not one of those games. Celeste never makes me calm. Crossing is a comfort game. Like, I don't really think there's a lot of stress with Animal Crossing. I mean, you know, don't talk to our friends and you probably wouldn't find it, but Animal Crossing is not meant to be a stressful game. The only reason why it's not my cup of tea is because I don't like games that use real-world clock systems. I know everyone can do, like, time travel, and there's nothing wrong with that. I just don't like it. See, I can't even say that I don't like raising games because I love Stardew Valley, so that would be a lie, but it's the real-world clock element. Funny enough, I also don't like Atelier games for the same reason. Which is weird, because I tried to like Atelier games, like I really tried to do it, but oh no. I can't do with like real-world clock and like limited clock. Yeah. What's it called? Atelier games are like ridiculous. Like, there's literally like, I mean, I guess Persona's the same way, but I'm fine with Persona 5. I'll say Persona 5 because I'm not fine with Persona 4. I liked Persona 3 though. Like, I can't say like, oh yeah, I don't like Persona games because like, I was neutral. Oh, not neutral. I was okay with 3. I liked 3. I like 3, but I think I only played like Persona 3 once, and like, I guess I can say I was pretty young, it was like high school, and like, that's young to me now. Oh, that's so scary. Oh, I tried to run. I was having so much fun talking about JRPG narrative goals that I didn't even realize I was already on the Theo bit and dying like a lot. Hey, don't do that. Theo, no! Yeah. But I mean, I just like narrative in games in general. Like it on it, like I always see the like one of the more valuable things about games to me are the narrative rather than the gameplay, which is weird because like most of it's always the gameplay. Like, you know, there's a ton of games that we love that don't even have a narrative, or you know, don't have a very good one. They're like more excuse plot of anything. I mean, I would pretty much be lying if I said I liked games only that have story, and I play a lot of Tetris. Speaking of which, I haven't played Tetris 99 in a while. like... I know, right? It's just because, like, the intern that I have, is more into, designing game narrative. So he's actually- we actually had, like, a frustrating moment, a little, like, last week. Because, like, he was scared basically he had to do the whole video game himself and he doesn't know any programming. When he's like, all I wanted to do was narrative. And I was like, you know what? I mean, hey, like, I've been there. I still am there, probably. Theo, no! I need you! I need Theo. Oh. I mean, like, yes. Games need narrative. Not all narrative. But games can have a very compelling narrative. Like, there's a lot of stories that I believe can only be told through video games. Like, I can name like a million examples right now. Like, Nier Automata, like, would not have been the same if it was not a video game. Like, a very good example of like a book that does this kind of thing is House of Leaves. Like, you don't forget House of Leaves because of the way it's presented. I'm gonna die. Oh. I definitely liked writing those gaming papers. Like, if you guys ask my, one of my old college professors, I did, like, all his extra credit. Not because I needed the extra credit, I just wanted to write the papers. Yo, come on! Yo, let's go! Theo, no! Okay. Yeah. Last room. But yeah, there's definitely like story that can only be told through the narrative of video games, the way that it uses mechanics and everything. 999 is another game like that. It's just like using technology and using media to like, I don't want to say it's full of. Because obviously, like, there's no, like, pinnacle of technology or gaming, like, that's just, like, the everything at once. But it's using multiple, like, video games are honestly, like, the most, they're the best example of mixed media for art. Because there's art, there's technology, and, like, they all work together to make the full story. Art, technology, writing. Even more than that. In more senses. Because then we have, like, empathy, logos, pathos, ethos, all that. Theo! Docs, I'm just a giant nerd who loves video games. And I love video games in the way of, like, analysis and all that. So... like, there's deeper meaning in writing, and then, like, I know that, like, a lot of times, like, people argue, like, well, if you understand too much, you won't, like, enjoy it. There is an element of truth to that. Because, like, I definitely have that weakness in that, like, I can't enjoy certain things because I know it's not the best that it could be. Or anywhere near, like, the best it could be. But that's the thing, like... by understanding something and getting that fuller appreciation of it, you can appreciate things more. You can appreciate the things that you already love even more. Like, Pokemon doesn't have, like, the greatest story, but it has a very fun gameplay element. Like, I will still buy every new Pokemon game that comes on the shelf. Oh yeah, I forgot! I forgot I named myself! This always takes me by surprise. I always forget that I do this in my speedruns. Ow.
Ha
Here's me. Here's me getting deep about video games while I have this laughing block carrying me through the level. Oh no. Oh no. But yeah, like, a narrative doesn't even have to be complex to be good. Like, look at Celeste that we're playing right now. This has like a simple message and it's like an amazing story. And then there's the games that have the deep lore that are like great because they have the deep lore, like Undertale. People analyze that game for freaking years. And they are still analyzing it. Ugh-gah-gah. Oh, for real. Like, if you locked us in a room for like, if you gave us a TED Talk time, like freaking 5 hours, I'll go past that while still talking about video games. Let's go. Let's go. Freaking dead. I mean, if you freaking want deep lore. See, if you want a good example of something that went too far into deep lore, it's called freaking Ow, Kingdom Hearts. I invoked its name and died. Yeah, if you ever want an example of plot overload, there you go. I didn't even need to call him again. I just wanted to hear his laugh. What? Look how good I am at darts. Ow! Look how good I am at darts! No, don't leave me behind! No, come back! Ow! I just want you all to hear Covert Muffins laugh like over and over. That's why I'm dying. Yeah. Ow. Yup. You're gonna see my best strats plunt. Let's see if I can one-shot the boss without dying. Well. Clint, are you streaming on Friday? Are you gonna have another poetry stream? See, this is the fun thing. With all like the working from home, all the casuals have to realize that like we had the right idea all along. AKA, I still love it when I see all those Twitter posts of like streamers who are like, yo, I get to use my streaming setup for work. And I'm like, please. I want to like figure out how to get an overlay on my Zoom account. So I can do a stupid like gamer overlay in my meetings. And then get fired. I probably wouldn't get fired, but I would get heavily lectured on, like, this is not professional. Oh my word, I died. Nice. That was my knife, I died. Let's go. My streams aren't varied enough to, like, do a whole week. Then again, I did like every day when I was like unemployed, so I don't know what I'm talking about. Nailed it! That is very true. Nailed it. Nailed it. Yeah! Nailed it! Ow. High level gameplay. High level. High level. What am I doing? See, that's why I feel that Animal Crossing is a really fun game to stream. But, like, everyone is streaming it, so I imagine I was right. Because it's, like, it's varied. It's like streaming Breath of the Wild. Like, like someone's always going to be doing something different. Like, you're not going to walk into, like, the same Animal Crossing stream with people. I mean, this you will, because it's a speedrun. I mean, I guess mine is different in that it's a speedrun that's going very badly, but... Like, most of my streams, since they're JRPGs, I only get to stream them once, because it's like, well, there's a story. You got it. It's like, I'm not really gonna play it again, because, yeah. No. Yeah, those craft streams are getting, like, really fun, too. No! I mean, like, Pokemon streams were kind of the same as well. Well, I know, like, actually, yeah, Pokemon's a little more linear. But, like, usually people had, like, different types of Pokemon, so, like, it was different enough. Nailed it! I know, the popular thing is tarantula, like all these weird tarantula strats for Animal Crossing. Apparently, from what I've seen on Twitter, you can destroy wasps with like party crackers or something, and I'm like, okay. There we go. Timing. Covert motion is gonna save me. Nope. Yeah, and I'm like, okay. Can like every animal like, or not animal, but every bug that's evil, like, be defeated now? Actually, no, like, it's kind of cute that they can be, because, like, they're not easy methods. Like, it's just people finding crazy, like, strats, which I think is very adorable. Like, that they put them in, but, like, they didn't make them, like, they made them pretty well hidden. So you can continue to live your happy Animal Crossing life. Oh, it's big boy! Yeah! Big boy will carry me through! Oh, that's why. It's incentive because they're harder to get, but like, they give you a lot of money. Come on, clean battle and run, let's go! Aw, oh, dang it! I'm never gonna have a clean battle in. One of the tricky- the things I always forget is that, like, in the early laser fight, she does switch up. That always throws me off. Ah! death cycle. Oh, I don't have a dash left. I'm done. Definitely my favorite track in the entire game, though. In fact, honestly, hearing this track in the trailer is why I even bought it. Okay, I can't say I bought this game. Someone bought it for me. But hearing this track in the trailer isn't what made me want this game. Thank you, Clint. Thank you for introducing me to this game that I torture myself over because of speedrunning. They have like the beginning jingle the beginning jingle mixed in for like the B-side, but I want to hear it authentically on a tape. Shoutouts to a fan gamer like actually making a physical tape. It's not even that they're getting harder to find, it's harder to find a system that will play them. I don't even think I have like a tape player left in my house. I lost my flow and now this level's bad. So hard in the one like the one room you can't die. Sorry if you like that cutscene. Ow. Okay, I'm not usually this bad. What the heck? Oh, you bonked, Madeline. You bonker. She's a bonker. Oh my goodness. I can't believe you actually bonked again. Amazing. Oh, Madeline! So bad! So bad! Ow! Stop! Stop
other one.
Right. No, why'd you do that, Madeline? Ow. Oh, that was bad. Should have done something weaved more. Okay. Oh, so cruel. Gotta give me more of a hitbox than that, girl. Oh, that was stupid. Let's go. Why would you give me a save point here? You can't die. Plunt strives to meet his challenges. And it's almost, I was about to say tomorrow, tomorrow's the 31st, but it's almost April, Plunt! Poetry month! Gotta get that poetry in. Are you gonna do a poem a day? Oh, wait, no, I think you did like a poem a week last year. No, actually, no, I think you did a poem a day. Oh, that was bad. It's almost time, Plunt. I mean, I'm pretty sure, like, Poetry Month is gonna be very popular this year. Year. I mean, I know it was there when you did complete it, because I enjoyed reading all your poetry. It's a chill stream tonight, Docs. We're just talking about everything that interests us while I try to ignore the searing sciatica pain in my leg. It is still there and present. But see, only do like Poetry Month if you- don't do that! Only do Poetry Month if you want to, don't like burn yourself out. I've like burnt myself out on like a couple of NaNoWriMos. Like, I mean, not recently. It was like a long time ago. College days. College day NaNoWriMos. I mean, it doesn't help that, like, I don't know. I had like my home convention and finals. And I'm like, yo, I'm gonna do NaNoWriMo this year. I burnt myself on NaNoWriMo like twice. I don't even think I have like the fruits to even show for it, which sucks. I burnt myself out on some writing Big Bangs as well, which sucks. Because then you actually let people down. That's what I hate about it. There we go. I wouldn't feel guilty. Just because you don't write a lot doesn't mean you don't write something. Writing, just having like an outcome is something. It's something more than nothing. That's like one of the bigger lessons I had to teach myself when I was writing fanfiction. It's like, sure, like, the topic sucks and it's very niche or whatever, but like, you'll regret more not having written it than writing it. That's usually the metric I used to judge myself. If I would regret not writing it more than writing it, then I'd rather just write it. Not that that part's easy, but... I mean, I still have to write my freaking wing verse. And that was for when I was into house, like, freaking 10 years ago. Maybe even 10. Probably like 15 by now. It's not diagonal. Salute. Don't do that either. Okay. Yeah. No. Oh, I did not think I was gonna survive that. Holy frick. I didn't survive that. Oh, I messed up. Why do I keep doing that? Jump off of something, you're always gonna land in a lower spot. Not the same spot. That's fifth. Thank you. Oh yeah, Plunt like showed me that video about what was it? Like the, it was like the black, was it the black plant page or like the forbidden page or something? As you can tell, my biggest weakness is music. I don't know anything about like the mechanics and like the base of music, like the foundation of it. But that's what makes it fascinating because I don't know it. And that's why I always like love hearing people talk about it, because it's like, it's never something that's clicked in my brain. It's like how Sherlock Holmes, like, his weakness is astronomy. My weakness is music. Music fundamentals and all that. And not even just music, like at its base level, rhythm. I don't understand rhythm. The black page! Ow. I mean, like, I don't really think you drum one. I mean, maybe you do, I don't know. But yeah, like, they definitely in that video had a mastery. Like, to have drums sound so smooth like that at that pace. I forgot what the pace is called in music. It's not rate, that's math. I have made that mistake so many times where I like press start to skip the cutscene and then I had to retry the level. I know, like, drummers have like this such an innate sense of rhythm. Like, ow. Yeah, I think you can learn drums. I can see you like taking to drumming. Can drummers also be vocalists? Like, you can vocalize while you're drumming in the back. Maybe that's why you never took the drum. Like, isn't it hard to be, like, a solo drummer? I mean, I don't know. I don't really know much about music, so, like, I don't think, like, I never think of drums as, like, a solo instrument. I could be wrong. Probably am, but unfortunately, while I've been enjoying everyone else playing Animal Crossing, which is a great game, it's not my cup of tea because what's it called? I don't like real world clock games. I like play games on my own time. Animal Crossing has been like really cute. I love some of the villagers that have been introduced. Like, I think there's like some very cute wolves I've seen. But yeah. sucks too, because like everyone's been playing it. Yeah, it's rhythm. Like, I feel that drums are kind of like, what's it called, of like the band. They're like the, they assist with harmony. Like, they keep all of, like, the other band members on pace. The drums are very crucial, but it's like, it's a very, like, teamwork kind of thing. Yeah, they're a good foundation. Why'd I do that? But yeah, like, I'm glad everyone's loving Animal Crossing, especially during these trying times. I kept joking, like, earlier this month, I was like, man, if Animal Crossing had just come out, like, a week earlier, I feel that a lot more people would have it. But I mean, I'm sure it's been making a killing on online sales, so... I'm also glad, like, that game came out, like, at a time when everyone, like, needed it. Madeline, catch your wife! Nice. That's very good. That's perfect timing right there. That's another reason why I got Persona 5. Persona 5 came out on my birthday. Royal did it, so I didn't bother getting it. Drums are a very interesting instrument. Like, it's a, like, it's, that's what I love about, like, musical instruments in general. And, like, that's one of the fascinating things about drums. It's, like, it's such a simple concept, but there's so much, like, difference you can get into it. Like, even the same song on a piano, it's different depending on who plays it. I think it's, like, cadence is the term? And, like, how you play it. Ow. I play Doom Eternal every day at work. It's called Zoom Eternal. I'm always in like my freaking Zoom meetings. Freaking 8 hours a day. When I'm not in a Zoom meeting, I'm preparing for another Zoom meeting. I'm so popular, you guys. Yeah, Tombra. That's what it is. I know medical terminology, but not musical terminology. No. Oh, Cadence is voicing, isn't it? I thought Cadence was harmony. Or maybe I'm thinking Cadence. Oh, really? Like, even, like, little things like humidity matter for pianos, too? That's interesting. I thought it was, like, I thought a lot of it depended on the player. Like, I mean, I know that, like, the piano they use also matters. But, like, I thought a lot of it was the player. Like, you know, how fast they hit the keys, like, when they decide to hit the keys, like, the different kinds of, the decisions they make, like, in that split second when they play them, that's always kind of fascinating. Like, it's similar to speedrunning in a way, like, you know, what I'm doing right now. Simple things like little jumps at the right time in the right position, that can make an entire difference in my router room. And the same thing goes for, like, the same song played on piano. Plunt taught me that recently, like, okay, so that's what it is. It's not, like, a massive thing. But yeah, like, Plunt taught me recently about, like, sheet music, and that, like, I never realized it was just kind of, like, a guideline. I thought, like, sheet music was, like, a strict kind of thing. Like, that's, like, the, that's what was always fascinating to me about music. Like, little elements can make an entire difference in a thing, in a song. It's a map. But like, yeah, like, people say that music is like, is a language. I mean, I guess so is coding, but... That's why, like, it's really interesting to know, like, the concepts of linguistics. Because then you realize, like, a lot of things, like, they don't readily seem like music are music. Like, coding... coding, music, it's all language. It's not as apparent as, like, cultural languages. Catch the crystal, Madeline! As dumb as it is, like, speedrunning is probably, like, its own language. I mean, it is! It's, like, its own set of slang. I mean, I guess in comparison, it's, like, freaking, like, thieves can't. Rather than, like, a language, but... I mean, like, I think at the end of the day, like, I think what fascinates me is language because I am, like, a freaking English nerd. Ow! Oh, yeah! I remember. My name is Bisha. Thank you for attending my TED Talk on how everything is language. That too is language. See, it's like, I'm less of like a language buff than I am just like the meaning behind things. That's why I feel that I am into rhetoric. Even though my boss said don't get a master's in rhetoric. Yeah, exactly. That's the fascinating thing about language. But like, I think that's the secret of rhetoric. Rhetoric is taking like that, because like language itself is like a base concept. It's all conception. But the magic of rhetoric is manipulating the interpretation that people have to generate the outcome that you want. That's the secret of rhetoric. It's the message in things, but it's also controlling that message to communicate what you want. So it's that mastery of generating the same thought you have in someone else. Inception. Inception is rhetoric. I solved the world's problems, you guys. I did it. Yeah. Oh yeah. What's the name of the channel? Cause I know Plunt and I have been watching some stuff like that too. When we're not watching darts. Or we're not watching darts or Polygon. Oh yeah, I think I've watched some stuff for them, from them. I think they did like a game. I think they analyzed like a Game Grumps video, and that's how I found them. Good thing I got that flag! Yeah, it was Adam Neely that we were watching. I think he was the one that, like, he took on the Black Page challenge. And he was also, no, like, he was the one that, like, put music to emotes, didn't he? And they weren't, like, jingles. They were, like, actual musical communication. I got... Yeah. Oh, you should watch that video. It was a fun video. Yeah, we watched the drummer do the Black Page, And we watched that guy, like, like, he was explaining his, reasoning for some of, like, the tracks he did to emotes. It was very fascinating. Come on, sub 30! That's me, who's gotten this under sub 10! Whatever. Again, like, my bigger goal in all of this is building up the muscle memory. And not dying. Oh yeah, it was a duo, that's right. Or was it a collab? I think it was a collab. Oh, I would totally watch that Chrono Trigger video. Because Chrono Trigger has some amazing music. Like, I mean, like, it's amazing, don't get me wrong, but it's very, like, traditional RPG. But, like, it's quintessential traditional RPG, is what my opinion of it is. Like, this is the stuff that, like, if someone asked for an example of, like, what is JRPG music, you would point them to Chrono Trigger. I mean, it even has, like, an album, the cover is just, like, bacon and eggs. And it's to symbolize, like, the simplicity of waking up in the morning. It's ridiculous, it's great. I love Chrono Trigger. Like, it's stuff that, like, sticks with you. Like, I mean, like, I feel that Zelda music has left more an impression on me, but, like, Chrono Trigger is definitely that quintessential JRPG. And Zelda is just Zelda, so. See, Zelda has the advantage of having a legacy with it, so it can reuse tracks. Don't think of it as Shadow Dogs. We muse and stuff because we have the experiences in it. Well, I don't super, but I have, like, pros, because I'm, like, a pros person. Like, a lot of the stuff I've been saying is wrong. And that's why, like, everyone over here is trying to guess what I mean. Because I don't super know a lot. But it's all about a learning experience. That's why people like TED Talks. It's because if you learn from them. You don't become, like, a subject matter expert overnight. And the real reason you even become, like, a subject matter expert is because it's stuff that you're interested in. Everyone has to start somewhere. Like, things that fascinate you, you're not gonna be, like, a master of immediately. Oh yeah, Chrono Trigger is very jazzy. I never realized that. I mean, like, they have, like, cadence of Hyrule. To give it more of, like... See, like, Chrono Trigger has, like, the interesting thing because it's, like, it symbolizes multiple points in time. That's why it has, like, multiple kind of, like... I don't want to say genres. It's not super genres. But, like, Zelda basically kind of had a more uniformity to it because it's kind of a little bit of the same. You know, there wasn't, like, that varying of timelines and stuff. Like, there's always, like, that was weird. I mean, like, we now have Cadence of Hyrule to show, like, versatility and stuff, but even that, it's the traditional Zelda flavor. Just with, like, a different kind of spice, which is exciting. Because, don't get me wrong, like, freaking Cadence of Hyrule sounds like magical. But yeah, like, Zelda definitely had, like, a uniformity to it. Like, even before Ocarina of Time, it kind of used kind of... not the same instruments, because they're very varied instruments, but, like, it's the same kind of, like, feel of instruments. Like, you know, Cadence of Hyrule obviously isn't, like, super considered part of the Zelda canon, but it's, like, name for me, like, a Zelda game that had, like, super different music, and I don't think you really... I mean, like, nothing's wrong, anything wrong with that. It's just the charm of it. But, like, Zelda basically has its flavor and sticks to it. Oh, I don't like my voice. I think it's very gravelly. I'm very loud when I'm like excited about stuff, but like I definitely have a lot of thinking. Like, it's a lot of prose. I'm a very prose person. Ow. Like, I'll wax on and on about something I don't even know about because of my freaking nature of prose. Yeah, it's a very serious song. Like, I'm pretty sure I've watched a video about someone analyzing, like, the parts of, like, the songs. Like, it wasn't even until Skyward Sword that I realized that the Hyrule field theme is more complicated than I realized. But Serious Song is very simple. Zelda's Lullaby isn't. Which is fascinating. Song of Storms, I think, is pretty simple. I mean, like, listening to it, but it's like simple that like it sticks in you. Like, it's unique in that like it leaves an impression. I mean, simple is not always bad, obviously, but like, yeah. Ow, that's a frick. Yeah, it's pretty. I had a good idea. Epona song is not like that simple. It has like a little bit of like an undertone to Epona song. Like, it has a very homey. I mean, like, that's obviously what they were going for. They were going for like Wild West, which is like the like family kind of deal. Like, it's like, well, actually no, I can't compare it to that. But like, what I was thinking of is when you communicate feeling through like music, that's something that Pokemon did pretty well. Like, to this day, even the Pallet Town theme is still very iconic to me. Like, it holds a special place in my heart. I mean, it could be the rhetoric of it, it could be the story behind it and the lore, but like, Ocarina of Time's Pallet Town theme will always make me think of it. I'm pretty sure more of that is on the rhetoric side than like what the song itself actually communicates, but it also has like a very simple, homey feeling. Yeah! I mean, like, you get the feeling of that from Ocarina of Time. Like, I know they didn't like rush it. Like, there's a lot, obviously they didn't rush it. Like, the whole story behind Ocarina of Time is that like, we're gonna release this game late because we're gonna release it well. It's gonna be a good game. But yeah, like, it's like, Zelda music itself has like a flavor in that as soon as you hear it, you know this is the Zelda game. It's unmistakable. Oh yeah, that's fine. Was it the original manual? See, like, one of the things I didn't even realize, because, like, I'm bad at music, is, that, like, you can play a lot, like, the ocarina that they provide in the game is actually very versatile, and that you can play a lot of things with it. I had no idea how people were figuring it out. Yeah, go to bed. I'm almost done with my speedrun, so, you know, once I, like, make it up the mountain. See, you wouldn't believe this, but I'm actually pretty good at this game! It doesn't seem like it, I know. I've beaten this game in under an hour. No one's gonna believe me. Yeah, they sell those at cons a lot. I know, like, before when I was younger, I was so jealous because they had, like, it in a magazine. And I was like, oh my freaking word, I can play an ocarina! In the game! And like, my mind was blown. Why can I not get this spring? Ugh. Oh my goodness. Oh, guys, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna stop doing my TED talk and make it up this freaking mountain. Hello, my name is Visho. I freaking wax poetic about things I actually don't really understand anything about. I just go on and be like, man, I think that's fascinating because of this. That's completely my opinion, and in no sense true, but I prose about it a lot. Plunt, you're so lucky! You're so lucky, Plunt! Hey, you guys, you're in the credits now. What kind of Zelda stuff did you get? There wasn't that much Zelda merch, if I recall. So cute though, Plunt. I'm imagining you on Christmas morning getting your little Zelda presents. Here, enjoy the Celeste credits as the stream is over. I'm gonna drink. See, I wasn't gonna put this on the YouTube channel because I sucked at all the gameplay, but then we had a giant TED talk, so I guess I'll put it on the YouTube channel or whatever. Plunt! Oh my goodness, Plunt, please! Please, Plunt! Oh my word! I'm so excited for Friday now, Plunt! Like, for real. Now I'm super excited. Now I'm super hype. It's okay. You don't have to contribute. It's just, it's fun to be interested in stuff. It's fun to want to learn. Plunt, I'm so excited, Plunt, Pharrell! Yes! See, Plunt, we've all been to, like, Ocarina of Time recently because Mint's been streaming randomizers. The Ocarina of Time randomizer is exciting. She streamed the item randomizer, and then she streamed an item and door randomizer, and that was quite something. You can totally stream. I'm gonna have a late night stream a little bit tomorrow just because, like, it's the last day of March. But if you want to stream, go ahead. I'll probably just do, like, a random run and just call it a night or something. Just to say I did. So I could say I streamed at the end of March. Yeah. That sounds good. TGH! I remember Ni No Kuni. I didn't have time to play it. Half? He's in the credits. That's cute. Okay, guys. Good night. I will see you on the Discords. Bye!